Mr. Butler, is there any rebuttal?
Yes, sir, I will call Sheriff Piper in the body.
Sheriff? Raise your right hand. You swear the testimony you're about to give in this hearing will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help me God.
I do.
Have a seat, Mr. Butler.
Sheriff Piper, can you please introduce yourself to the board?
Duane Piper, Sheriff Forsyth County.
When did you take office?
January 1st, 2013.
Can you explain to the board any changes you have made in, I guess, the human resources area of your office?
Not a lot of changes, I understand. We're staying more involved in the human resources action, the human resources function for the previous sheriff probably did. Policy-wise, what are you asking?
Well, no, just in general, just, I'm sorry. Does your office have its own set of policies?
We do.
And who establishes or approves those policies?
I approve. They're established through legal research, meeting with command staff and research by our internal affairs, come up with our policies, and then they're approved through a staff process, and then I sign off on the file.
Well, let me ask you this. Are your deputies covered by the County Civil Service Office?
Oh, yes.
And what are your thoughts on that?
I think it's one of the valuable tools we have for employee morale and for their protection. It's, in my mind, pretty much indispensable that we have civil service protection for adverse job action for employees.
I couldn't hear you. Your last part.
I think it's essential that we have civil service protection for employees for adverse job actions.
Policy says, dismissal for disciplinary reasons may be instituted without prior notice when deemed necessary to protect the agency or the employee concerned. There's been testimony that Mr. Wood objected
as to leaning and him repeating testimony.
Fine.
Rephrase the question.
Did Mr. Whitfield get prior notice before May 30th that he was going to be terminated?
As I said, I was out of town, but I was advised of the process, how it occurred, made sure that Chief Deputy had no problems, everything was done correctly. And yes, Major Hoffman conducted a pre-dismissal interview, a pre-dismissal meeting with him before they went into the actual dismissal. And the thing that sticks in my mind, what I remember most clearly, was that during the pre-dismissal part of it, Mr. Whitfield seemed to think that this was some type of negotiation rather than pre-dismissal. His words were, I thought this was a negotiation. I remember that specific part.
You know who Ms. Pat Carson is?
I do.
Was Ms. Carson notified of Mr. Whitfield's dismissal prior to him being terminated?
No, we didn't notify her until afterwards.
Okay.
This is the civil service policy, the county policy, concerning dismissal. Section 8. Do you see that?
I do.
Okay. It says, if you would read to me, the fourth line in the policy starting with N.
In the event of such dismissal, is that what you're going to read?
Yes.
In the event of such dismissal, the applicable elected official / department head shall notify the human resources director no later than the end of the following business day.
Okay. And it says, that's when you have a safety problem, right?
Does it say that in here?
A dismissal shall be instituted without prior notice when deemed necessary to protect the county or the employee concerned. In the event of such a dismissal, the applicable elected official shall notify the HR director no later than the end of the following business day. Do you see that?
That's what it said, yes.
And you didn't do it?
No, we didn't.
So you violated the policy?
This is not my policy.
But you violated this policy?
No, this is not my policy. This is county policy.
So you violated the county's policy.
This is from the county manager. This is not our policy.
So the county manager, in this is a separation policy that applies to all employees who are separated from employment with Forsyth County. And it says elected official in this policy, does it not?
It does. It says that.
But you don't want to follow that policy. Is that your testimony?
No. We made our own policies that are consistent with the way it says we do the civil service.
If, Sheriff,
those are the ones.
Consistent means if you have a one-day notification, then it's consistent with their one-day notification, right?
Consistent means a whole broad range of things. But to have two policies that folks have to follow, you make it unmanageable.
Oh, I see. So 10 days later, when you actually did give the policy, the termination paperwork, I should say, to the county, that was managed.
I'm not familiar with when we gave it to the county.
Well, let me ask you to assume that the county got it 10 days after the dismissal. It also says in this policy, you do receive the county's money, do you not?
In a budget at the beginning of every
year. And your employees do receive benefits, right?
They do.
Do you receive health insurance through the county?
I do.
Do you receive benefits through the county?
Yes.
Do you not accept those benefits?
I do.
Do you get paid by the county when you take sick leave?
Actually, it comes out of my budget. Sheriff's budget.
Is it your personal pocketbook that's being picked?
Sheriff's office budget.
Okay.
Sheriff's office budget.
And who funds that? People?
Yes.
How do they fund it?
Through taxes.
And you take that money, and it's administered through the county?
Correct. Yes.
It also says, in all other cases, let's read, look at it with me. It also says, however, in other cases, the applicable elected official should notify the human resources director of his or her intent to dismiss an employee at the reasons therefore prior to dismissal. You see that?
I see that.
Did you notify Pat Carson of the reasons prior to dismissal?
We did not.
So let me understand. I got to understand. It was you who made the decision to terminate Paul Whitfield, yes or no?
Which time? At what point? Initially, it came from Major Hoffman.
I'm talking about the final decision.
The final decision only was.
You don't have to accept that decision.
I don't.
You have complete discretion.
I do.
So you yourself have had problems with truthfulness in the past, haven't you? You haven't. Not even when you were with Glynn County?
No.
Let me show you a document about truthfulness.
Can I have this mark, please?
You were a captain at St. Simon's Island, were you not?
Absolutely not. No, I'm not a captain.
I'm sorry. You were a patrolman?
Yes.
You worked for W.R. Pittman, did you not?
I'm not sure.
Let me show you the give you a reflection of your recollection.
We're over 20 years ago.
I'm going to show you what's marked for purposes of recollection, PW13 at this time.
Do you have a copy of that, sir?
I do.
Thank you.
In fact, let me go ahead and mark it as PW13 and ask you to identify it.
Yes, I'm sorry, I didn't remember Captain Pittman's name.
Okay.
Yeah, I do remember.
Tell us about being truthful back then when you were a patrolman at the Glynn County Police Department.
I called in sick to work and went and played in a golf tournament and received an 8-hour suspension.
Okay, so you lied about that, did you not?
No, they asked me what I did and I told them and I got an 8-hour suspension.
Okay. Well, you also had another warning, did you not? You appealed it, by the way, did you not?
Oh, absolutely, I did.
Okay. You said that you were appealing the severity of your punishment for calling in sick to work on 2/17/90. My past record of attendance, 13 months without use of any sick days, along with my job performance, should be taken into consideration when determining punishment. Do you see that?
I do.
Okay. You were accused, were you not, of taking a sick day to play golf, were you not?
He's been asked and answered. He's asked him about this incident. Sheriff Piper's already explained it. I don't know why we need to keep going into it.
Go ahead.
I was calling accused.
Sheriff, let me rule on the objection. Objection is sustained. Go ahead and ask your next question.
So I just want to understand that you agree that the HR department was not, that is, the county HR department was not notified prior to his termination, Mr. Whitfield's termination, right?
They were not notified, no.
And you will also agree that after his termination, it took 10 days for them to receive the notification.
I can't agree with that. I don't know how long it took us to be notified. Clarify what I said about that, though? I do recall that incident specifically.
Does any attorney have any questions?
Well, sure. If you'd like to clarify that, go ahead, Sheriff.
I called in sick and played golf, and I was asked what I did that day. There was no misdirection or anything else. I said, I went and played golf. And he said, well, you're getting suspended for that. And I took my 8-hour suspension. I appealed it and asked them to reconsider how severe it was because I'd been missing time. And they said, no, I took my time. We'll make sure. I think the attempt to be characterized by misleading somebody. I was asked about it and I told them what I did.
And so, really and truly, though, you know the importance of a full and fair investigation.
Asked and answered.
Nuts. He's on cross.
I do, but that was a quick one. They asked me and I told them.
Any questions by members of the board? No.
You have a question?
Yeah, just a couple of questions. First of all, Sheriff, I want to commend you for the number of years of service you've had in this county. You've worked here in several capacities, quite some time. Appreciate especially the job you and your command staff did in your department with courthouse units. Just got a couple questions I'd like to ask, just very direct questions. The long and short of it is, why was Mr. Whitfield fired?
Because he wasn't being truthful. We were asking him questions about his communications with a person who just arrested for serious felonies.
Stated that you're, with the exception of the six appointed members of your command staff, that civil service protection is important for sheriff's office employees.
It's absolutely vital.
In your opinion, do you feel like the civil service policy was followed in this particular situation?
I do. I've not been told or shown anything legally that anybody in my command staff or my chain of command failed to follow our policy.
Thank you, Sheriff.
I do have a question, Sheriff.
Yes, sir.
We've known each other for a long time. I have two questions. Your command staff did not follow the civil service guidelines for whatever reason and whatever you want to say, but based on the guidelines that this board has used in the past, not followed. First of all, there was not a checklist placed on the back, and that's part of it. And that was violated. And second of all, according to the civil service guidelines, you were required, your command staff, not you, but your command staff, was required to submit to the Human Resource Department within 24 hours after the firing of Mr. Whitfield. That was not followed. Those two things were not followed. The thing that I'm most concerned about is that in all the days of working with the Sheriff's Department, I've been on this board for over 20 years, the Sheriff's Department, while they have had human resource people within the department, there's never been a human resource department set up the way that you're setting it up. And I understand a lot of the motives of why you explained one of those about leaks and all that. But in setting that up, and I'm not opposed to you setting it up if you go through the proper channels. Now, I don't know exactly what those proper channels are, whether it's to go to the Board of Commissioners or what. Some way or the other, it should be legitimate supplies so that all employees are under the same guideline. Now, I'm going to tell you now, and I may not should say this, but this board has never been as concerned about the notification of termination, pre-dismissal hearing, especially in the Sheriff's Department because of the reasons that have been cited. I would never say that the civil service guideline was violated because of that, because of the people you deal with have weapons. Now, I know the rules have been changed, but the other guidelines need to be standardized with the county. I don't know how you're going to do that, and you can go back and talk to your human resource people. Lori Conrad should have known that a checklist should have been attached to the packet. Doesn't seem like a major thing, but you see what happens. The person that's terminated, he and his team are going to use that as one of the items that wasn't followed. The other one was that, as of it stands today, your command staff was obligated to send Ms. Carson the notification. Now the board hasn't met and we haven't decided how this is going to turn out. But those two you did violate. So I'm concerned and I would encourage you that you get with your command staff and you get with the powers to be so that if you want to set up on your own human resource department, I don't oppose that, but it needs to be in a guideline and in such a manner that there would be no conflict between the two.
Any other questions? All right. May the sheriff be excused.
Please.
Thank you very much, Sheriff. Any further witness?
Nothing further.
Any rebuttals?
No.